And I want to introduce a very special man because he's been a friend of mine from the beginning. He's been with me. He said, you're going to win. You're going to win. He's a great political person. He's a leader. He's running against somebody who's so overrated. I mean, this guy. You know, I was telling a little story on Bob Casey. I have to do this before we introduce Lou. But so I've been in Washington now for more than a year and a half. I mean, honestly, I'm not sure I ever met Bob Casey. I'd never met him. And I'm sure I did. I shook his hand. But I'm not sure. Now, his father was a good man. Knew him a little bit. But we're dealing with a totally different person. I don't know this man. He's a senator. There are hundreds of senators. I don't know him. No, he's not an obstructionist. He's worse. He will do whatever Schumer, Pelosi, and the new star. And the new star of the Democrat Party tells him to do. You know who the new star, you know who their new leader is? Maxine Waters. Very low IQ. Low IQ. No, no, Maxine Waters is like, she's like their new star. But I want to introduce somebody that really is a star. He's smart. He's strong. He loves this state. People are just starting to know him, but I've known him for a long time. And you know, when he wants something for Pennsylvania, he is brutal. He's brutal. So if you would, Lou Barletta, please come out. Lou Barletta. Lou Barletta.
Thank you. Thank you. This is amazing. This is just amazing. You know, I never ever thought in my life that I would ever become a politician. I never thought that I would become a mayor. I never thought that I would become a congressman, but never in my wildest dreams did I ever believe that the President of the United States would come to my home area to help me win an election for the United States Senate. Thank you. Thank you. I'm grateful and humbled by that. You know, the economy is soaring under President Trump's economy. It is soaring. The market is up over 20%. Unemployment's at 4%. Black unemployment's at an all-time low. Hispanic unemployment's at an all-time low. Women's unemployment's at an all-time low. Small business confidence is at an all-time high. Consumer confidence is at an all-time high. There are more jobs now than people who are unemployed. ISIS is practically gone. North Korea is at the table. The wall's being built. Why would we ever stop that? We're not tired of winning, Mr. President. We're not tired of winning. But I want to tell you who wants to stop that. Bob Casey wants to stop that. He has become one of the most liberal senators in Washington. He is leading the resistance and obstruction to President Trump's agenda. He is so radical. He is so radical now that he said no to no matter who President Trump nominated for the Supreme Court. It didn't matter. He said no before he even mentioned who it was. He gave us Obamacare. He supports sanctuary cities. He wants to take away your tax cuts. He no longer represents the values of people here in Pennsylvania. Now listen, this seat is very important. It's very important because we want to keep that economy going. We want to once again show our law enforcement and first responders the respect they deserve. We want to take care of our vets. We want to honor our military. We want to to secure our borders. We want to put an end to illegal immigration once and for all. And we want to, and we want to take a knee to pray and stand for the flag. Now, I need everybody here. I need everybody here and everybody watching to help. Help me help President Trump drain the swamp and make America great again. Thank you.
He did a good job. So long, folks. What do I have to do? Bye. So, Lou, you don't know Lou. Some people, they don't know him well. I've known him well for a long time. All I had to do, I wanted him to get this position to run. I said, all I have to do is introduce Lou Barletta to the public a little bit, because he's known in his area, his district. He's like a legend. He was a great mayor, a great congressman. But the state didn't know him really as much, and tonight they all know him. This guy is a dynamo. He's incredible. And I have to say, you're dealing on the other side with the exact opposite. Lou mentioned some of the things, but when you think about Justice Gorsuch, you don't do better than that. You don't do better than that. And Casey voted against him. And now we have somebody that's extraordinary. As you know, Judge Kavanaugh. Yale College. Yale Law School. Top, top student. Top of everything. They predicted 15 years ago, when he was with a lot of other talented people, someday he'd be a Supreme Court judge. And you know what? I think Casey doesn't even want to meet with him. You know why? Because Schumer, Pelosi, and Maxine Waters told him not to meet. So he was no, and probably will be no. Maybe after tonight he'll vote yes, but I doubt it. Because his bosses are telling him what to do. And they always have. Not the father, but the son, yes. So they have no on Kavanaugh, no on Gorsuch, no on massive tax cuts. In fact, Casey and the group, they want to end the tax cuts and increase your taxes. Somehow that doesn't play well. Somehow that doesn't play too well. And you know what else he was no on? The biggest thing that only really the business people in this room fully appreciate, he was no on regulation cutting. We had regulations that made it impossible to do business in this country. Highways would take 21 years to get approved. We have it down to 2 years, and it's going to be 1 year very shortly. Very shortly. And you know what? We want clean, beautiful water. We want crystal clear air. We want our air to be the best. It is right now. It's the best it's ever been. But you don't have to go through 97 different approvals over a 20-year period. And we may reject plenty, but we're going to reject them in a year, and they can go on to do something else. We're not going to take them down the line 20, 21 years, and then you have a 3-2 vote against the project where people work their entire lives to get it approved. So we've gotten rid of massive amounts of regulation. Bob Casey. Bob Casey was joining President Obama. And his horrible attacks on our clean coal industry. Bob Casey was making it absolutely impossible for the miners. And Lou Barletta was fighting on behalf of our miners, our mines, our companies, and our beautiful Pennsylvania clean coal. And Lou won, and so did I, and so did you. So now with Lou on our side, we've won that war on coal, and we're doing something else because we're putting these great miners, these are great people. You know, in West Virginia, great minds, great people. I said to the miners, you remember when Hillary Clinton said, we're going to close you up? Then she had to go down to Pennsylvania, right? Then she had to come to Pennsylvania.